Hey.
Shit. You trying to give me another heart attack?
No, I just...
It was rhetorical, for God's sake. Come on, don't look so lost. Take a look around or something. You know, spy a little. It's not like anyone's gonna stop you.
You look lost.
What's lost is my body. I know I got killed right here. And I know it sounds crazy, but I'd feel a lot better if I knew where my body was. Are you a detective or something? You might be my only hope.
Yeah, I'm a detective. Any idea who did it? That might lead us to your body.
I know they were old people. And I know they lived in this apartment building. Other than that, everything is hazy. But I was doing a lot of drugs at the time.
Sounds like you do need a detective. I'll see what I can find out from any older residents of the building.
Honey, they can probably hear you talking through the ceiling.
I hope they do. Every time we visit Jennifer in this place, it's the same.
A string of mysterious murders and disappearances. Now, in a shocking turn, a police detective falls victim.
Staring out the window. What good's that gonna do?
That girl collapsed like paper when Grace hit her. I still can't believe she died. It happened so fast. I've never seen Grace so crazy before. It must have been the lack of sleep. Thank God it's all over. I can finally watch TV in peace.
Look at that poor excuse for a man. Won't even get out of his chair. Likes that chair more than me.
Finally, some peace and quiet. All her parties. How can anyone sleep through music blasting like that? I think she was on drugs. Walter was so tired, he could barely stay awake for the 5 miles it took to drive to Smithwick Quarry. I couldn't believe he was able to find a pair of lock cutters that late at night. At least the music has stopped. Now we can finally sleep.
Shocking turn, a police detective falls victim.
Looks like Grace couldn't take the girls partying anymore, so she killed her and roped her husband into helping dump the body at Smithwick Quarry. I should get back and let her know. Turns out, the reason you can't find your body is because it's not in the building. It's at Smithwick Quarry, about 5 miles out of town.
Oh. Well, why'd they do it?
Your parties were keeping them awake at night. They finally got too tired and snapped.
I thought they were just being unreasonable. I didn't know they would do this. Thanks for your help. You have no idea how big a relief it is just knowing.
No problem.
You know, I never really liked cops. They were always giving me shit, telling me how I was messing up my life. We never saw eye to eye on things. But you really came through for me. Probably should have listened to what they were trying to tell me. Maybe then things wouldn't have ended up like this. Thanks again.
For Jennifer to move out of this dump.
Hope he doesn't ask any questions. He'll know I've tuned him out.
How the hell did it come back? Did I do that? Hey, come back!
Those notes aren't for you.
Great. Looks like some sort of code or something. All right, well, I made it up to the fourth floor before the police cart away the evidence.
She's getting too much sugar. I mean, that keeps kids awake, right?
How does a monster like you end up in a kid's closet?
Her daddy pissed off the wrong people. I was the one sent to expedite things. It was simple. I grab the girl, make a few threats, collect the money, then let her go.
What went wrong?
Her daddy tried to be a hero and got in my way.
Looks like it worked.
It got him killed is what it did.
You killed him, and what happened to you?
The people I worked for weren't big on second chances, but it looks like I'll get one anyway. I just have to wait. Death comes for us all. Little girls are no exception. I've got nothing but time, my friend.
It ain't about luck, Everine.
You got that right, buddy. My... sorry, track.
I never know if she likes me, or she's just being nice.
Poor guys. I remember when I still thought poker was a game of chance.
A few more good cards would help.
Cards are gonna biodegrade in your...
It's you! You're famous! Check out the TV.
I'm good, thanks.
This is by far the worst birthday party ever.
What do you mean? We got brews? We have TV?
What's the use of a party if you have to plan it? That's like work. No, I'd be fine just watching a video.
Guess that's an idea. What? Logistically speaking. So which was it, electrocution or slit wrists?
The razor. It was only supposed to be the razor. That's what the voices told me. The music was just something to focus on until I bled out.
So the radio was just an accident?
I started the cut. The warm water made my skin so soft, but I couldn't go through with it. The radio slipped off the edge when I was getting out. And I didn't want to die. It was the voices in my head that wanted me dead.
I'm sorry, kid.
Okay, folks, I need you to keep your distance from the scene here.
What happened up here?
I'm afraid that's still under investigation.
Why doesn't this guy answer Jill? She's got good questions.
My ears!
now. I should make sure I stay with these people when I go. What are they afraid of? That we'll be afraid of a killer? I'm afraid already.
Officer Morgan.
Why does everyone need the gory details? Scott would loosen up.
The Salem Police Department will get to the bottom of this.
Hey, Broyles. You seen that little girl that lives here? If she turns up, you come find me. Got it?
I need to finish investigating before I go somewhere else.
Actually,
Turn around. You're under arrest. So that's what I walked in on. Was he after the girl? Where'd she go?
I don't know how this will end. The killer is an enigma to the police and a lurking shadow in my own life. If only I can keep Joy from harm, I would do anything, even push her away, if it meant pushing her to safety.
Should get this photo to Rex for that Amber Alert.
Carla, do you have anywhere that I could stay just for a little
while? Oh, of course, dear. The Trojan's always here to help.
Out the window.
Gunned me down in the street and you didn't even check for witnesses? Like you're untouchable. That girl is my only lead. I need to find her.